Hi everyone, my name is Jasjit Baveja and I'm the Associate Director of Policy at MTAA, so the Medical Technology Association of Australia. In this capacity, my responsibilities are diverse, however I primarily focus on regulatory affairs. Beyond regulatory affairs, I also oversee clinical, code of practice and procurement. All of these areas and others that we cover at MTAA, such as industry policy, reimbursement, and advocacy, really play a vital role in shaping the landscape of medical technology in Australia. Now, one of the aspects that I'm really excited and find a lot of fulfillment in is the integration of education into the realm of regulatory affairs. Recognizing the importance of continuous learning and professional development, I spearhead initiatives to provide educational opportunities for regulatory professionals in Australia. And I do this with collaborating very closely with TGA to run workshops. And what these workshops do is they provide invaluable experience, they provide a chance to network and also skill enhancement. I completed my PhD in biomedical engineering and since then have had over 20 years of experience in the medical device regulatory space. I started my career at ResMed, and most of you would know ResMed is an Australian manufacturer. So I worked as a regulatory affairs manager in their ventilator space and later in the healthcare informatics space. Now, being an Australian manufacturer, it gave me experience not only in regulatory affairs, but also firsthand experience around product development for medical devices. Transitioning to Johnson & Johnson, I led their orthopedics portfolio. This was more from a Australian sponsor perspective, so I gained experience and insight into the nuances and intricacies that that area had to offer. I then transitioned to Boston Scientific, where I led the regulatory affairs team for ANZ, covering various therapy areas such as cardiology, urology, neurology. And despite all of the experiences I've had in the corporate sector, I really always had a passion for policy and advocacy. So when this role opened up at MTAA, I took the opportunity to pivot my career towards policy and advocacy. I'm also very privileged to be able to lecture in regulatory affairs to biomedical engineering students at the University of Newcastle and the University of New South Wales. And with that, I hope to instill knowledge into these students, whether they choose to have a career in regulatory affairs or work alongside colleagues in regulatory affairs. Key regulatory frameworks are the Therapeutic Goods Act of 1989, the Therapeutic Goods Regulations of 1990, and the Therapeutic Goods Medical Device Regulations of 2002. In addition to that, we also have guidelines, because as you can imagine, it's pretty hard when we are trying to interpret regulations. So there are guidelines that TGA puts out to help manufacturers and sponsors really understand what the regulations mean. Regulations, and in this case specifically those that govern medical devices, serve as a cornerstone for the medical technology industry. They're essential not only in ensuring patient safety, but to create a conducive environment that encourages innovation within the industry. So at the core, regulations ensure that there are stringent quality standards throughout the life cycle of the medical device. This includes design, this includes distribution, manufacturing, and by setting these standards, the regulations play a crucial role in safeguarding patient and public health by ensuring that only safe and effective medical devices are on the market. Moreover, what it does is it instills confidence in patients, in healthcare workers, and broader stakeholders that any device that has gone through this rigorous testing has met the scrutiny of the regulatory requirements. And what this does, what this confidence does, is it helps uptake of medical technology. It helps the uptake of novel medical devices, new innovation, and this ultimately supports the sustainability and growth of the medical technology industry. So in essence, what regulations do is they strike a delicate balance of safeguarding patient safety and promoting industry innovation. MTAA offers workshops in medical device regulatory affairs for regulatory professionals, those that are already in this profession and also those who want to start out in this profession. And they provide a comprehensive education on Australian medical device regulations. I discovered the need for such workshops during my own career journey, where I realized that there was a lack of consistent education in Australian medical device regulations compared to other jurisdictions. And the objective of these workshops is threefold. Firstly, it is to enhance patient access to medical devices by ensuring that the industry understands and has a clear guidance on how to meet TGA expectations. And by aligning with the TGA's assessor's expectation, industry can streamline their own regulatory processes and thereby have faster approval times and improved patient access to medical technology. Secondly, these workshops aim to provide clarity and consistency for regulatory professionals, for their employers, and also for recruiters. By participating in these courses, individuals can ensure that they have a good and thorough understanding of the regulatory requirements, which then helps enable and foster better communication and collaboration within their own teams. For employers, they know exactly the level of knowledge that the person that they are hiring has once they've done these workshops, so that they can then really navigate the complexities of the role for which they are hired. Similarly, for recruiters, it helps identify candidates with the specific regulatory knowledge and experience that they are looking for. Ultimately, what this does is it helps employers build regulatory teams that can ensure compliance and that drive successful access to medical devices for Australian patients. And lastly, it fosters a community of regulatory experts who can collaborate and share knowledge. And again, ultimately, this helps with the advancement of the medical device and technology industry in Australia. And we at MTAA believe that these workshops that we run in conjunction with TGA will contribute to the overall growth, success, and sustainability of the medical technology industry in Australia. And ultimate aim is always to help patients and the broader healthcare landscape. A few things for someone considering a career in regulatory affairs, or even if you're already in that space and want to advance your career. So technical skills are always very important. So continuous learning. The regulatory landscape is consistently changing, so make sure you are learning and keeping up to date with that. However, to really succeed, you also need the soft skills. You need strong communication so you can communicate with not only your internal stakeholders, such as your cross-functional teams, which will consist of your quality colleagues, your commercial colleagues, and others, but also communication with regulators such as the TGA is really, really important. Also seek opportunities to network with other regulatory professionals. So go to any networking events, join conferences, join any other regulatory professional associations, and that will further deepen your knowledge and allow you to have a decent exchange of information and build the whole community in Australia as a whole and make it stronger.